restaurants in the world. You know, the minute you decide you want to go into entrepreneurship, you're going to have to start cooking in your house or something, you know. You have to cut down a lot, you know, the minute you decide you want to go into entrepreneurship, because going into entrepreneurship requires a lot of sacrifice. And that's what I encourage the Nigerian youth to do. Make sacrifices today for your future.
Thank you very much. As an expert in leadership mentoring, do you think this is one thing we need to bring to the fore, the issue of leadership mentoring, so that we catch them young, that we start from primary school, from the basic education level, secondary school, and for the university. And of course, use the National Youth Service Scheme as an opportunity and a platform to mentor our youth.
Absolutely. I think that is perhaps, you know, the key. As I said, in my case, my mother was my mentor. A lot of people don't have that. And so those of us that have built businesses or that have worked in structured businesses, I worked in Shell, I worked in British American Tobacco. So I feel that
those are high-profile companies.
They're very structured businesses, and I have learnt a lot.
Okay.
I've learnt the values of discipline, of hard work, and of starting small. I mean, you can sit on one job in Shell for 10 years, you won't get promoted, and you can't even discuss it. Because you haven't, I mean, there's some basic exams that you haven't even been through, you haven't passed. So, that you know, these are very structured organizations. And I feel that people like myself, and certainly people in government, and people like yourself, we should play that mentorship, that role in the lives of young people. Take a few, sort of five young people, pull them to yourself, let them use you as a bouncing board for some of the decisions that they make. It's more sort of real, it's more real time, it's more quick, and you know, like what Chema was saying, it helps them take informed decisions
in life.
They learn from your experience, and
they use you as a standard.
Thank
you very much. So Chema, in one word, what do you think government should do in this regard, in the realm of leadership mentoring? Do you think is necessary?
Okay, before I talk about what I think government should do, I think government has done something already.
Good.
You know, through the UN program, you know, and by God's grace, I was one of the winners of the UN business plan competition the first year. But through the UN program, when you win, they don't just leave you, they assign mentors, you know, to each of those businesses, you know, to guide and mentor and, you know, just sort of be a bouncing board for some of the awardees, you know, and then awardees are made to apply. So the government has started something. What I strongly desire that government will do is expand that. Okay, so let's say the government cannot provide grants to everybody, but they can. For example, from this exercise, I hear the NIS made over $1 billion. Some of that money should be invested in training those youths who went out there to the stadiums and suffered, you know, and train them on some, take them through some entrepreneurial classes, and then link them to mentors, people who will advise and guide them as well.
And it's important that everyone comes up with a personal vision for themselves. I keep telling people, all the places I've worked, I work for me. Fumi and Co. This is my vision. This is what, if you ask me, where do you want to be in 10 years, in 20 years, I can tell you.
Thank you very much.
People need to do that.
Thank you very much. Viewers, the topic has been unemployment in Nigeria and, of course, the wheel out of it. We've discussed how to make Nigerian youth a job creator instead of a job seeker. And I've been privileged to have in the studio Fumi Obue, a leadership mentoring expert, and of course, an expert in human resources related issues, and of course, a publisher. Thank you for coming on the program.
Thank
you.
It's
nice having you. And of course, Chioma Izioma, a winner of the UWIN program and an educationist. Thank you very much. It's nice having you again.
Thank you, too.
Up next is our special interview segment. Stay tuned.